beautiful people, this is Giorgia from the Sicilian Cuisine Blog. Today we're gonna prepare a very traditional dish. It's called swordfish in Palermo style, which in Italian sounds like this.
E noi prepareremo il pesce spada alla palermitana. È un piatto tipicamente siciliano, tra i più rappresentativi della nostra terra. La Sicilia, il mare, il pesce spada.
See, as you can see, I'm not alone. I'm very excited. Here with me, I've got award winner, actor and director, Egidio Termine.
Good morning.
Who is obviously Sicilian. I'll help you with that. Okay, so now Egidio is preparing a battuto, which is a mix of extra virgin olive oil, lemon juice, salt. Would be for the marinade of the swordfish. So now we're gonna put the swordfish into the mix and we're gonna marinate for about 30 minutes. Now, Egidio, tell me, what is your relationship with food? Do you like cooking?
È un rapporto molto conflittuale perché mi piace molto mangiare, però mi piace anche stare in linea, però ogni tanto qualche trasgressione si può fare, come per un piatto di questo tipo, no? E poi a me piace molto cucinare, perché cucinare è creativo. Un regista è creativo, un regista che non sa cucinare non è un bravo regista, attenzione.
So basically he loves cooking because it's a very creative process. So he was saying that a good director is also a good chef, so someone who is really good at cooking. And he really likes to cook, but also to eat, which is obviously, sometimes he has to be really careful because, you know, have to keep in shape. So what's your favorite dish of Sicilian cuisine? Is there something that has a particular memory in your...
Eh sì, quando ero bambino, mi ricordo mia nonna preparava le melanzane fritte, le faceva a tocchetti, le melanzane, le friggeva per preparare la famosa caponata con le olive bianche, i capperi e l'aceto, l'agrodolce, insomma, era una cosa squisita. Ci occorreva molto tempo per preparare questo piatto, ma una volta che si preparava poteva stare anche una settimana chiusa nella dispensa. E ogni tanto, io mi ricordo da bambino, mi alzavo presto la mattina, prendevo un cucchiaino e prima del latte la mattina mangiavo questa.
Wow, ok. Bellissimo. So Gigi is saying that basically has a beautiful memory of his grandma cooking the caponata of eggplants or aubergine, which is a very traditional dish of Sicily. So yeah, when he was a kid, basically he used to like go and open the fridge and then have a little bit of caponata because it could stay for a few days there. So it's a very nice memory. And you, by the way, find the recipe of caponata in my blog as well. What you need to do after the swordfish has marinated is just put some breadcrumb on both sides. You can carry on doing it if you want. So, in your career, you have worked with so many brilliant actors and directors, like for example, Zeffirelli, Sofia Loren, Van Johnson, Alberto Sordi, Vanessa Redgrave, so incredible people. Is there something that they have actually taught you, or that you remember, like something very important that, you know?
Sono state tutte esperienze bellissime. Lavorare con i grossi attori è importante perché ti lascia sempre qualcosa per la tua formazione. Però devo dire, quello che mi ha dato di più di tutti è stato Alberto Sordi nel film Il Casinare a New York. Lui dirigeva ed era il protagonista. Io avevo un ruolo, una parte, e lui mentre recitava con me mi dirigeva con gli occhi, mi diceva, mi faceva capire in maniera naturale che cosa avrei dovuto fare in quel momento. Io penso che per essere un bravo regista devi essere stato anche un grande attore. E Sordi lo era sicuramente. Spero anch'io, eh.
Amazing. Okay, so basically Judy is saying that one of the things that he remembers the most is working with Alberto Sordi, who is a legend here in Italy. And he was working for a movie called Tassinaro New York, a cab driver in New York, and he was both director and actor, and he was helping him so much and giving him tips about how to perform, how to act, and yeah, he remembered basically how good he was. And the most important thing for him is that a director has to be also an actor, because it can help a lot in giving advice and stuff like that. So great. Perfect, now we start cooking the swordfish. So we put the heat on and we prepare our frying pan. A few minutes, because it has to be really, really hot, okay? Okay, Egidio, tell me something about your last piece of work, because you have actually made a movie which is called Il Figlio Sospeso, which in English has got a different title, which is The Unsure Son. Tell us about the story of this movie.
È un film che ha una tematica attuale da un punto di vista sociale, l'utero in affitto, la maternità surrogata, e lui è sospeso o unsure tra due madri, la madre naturale e la madre culturale. È un film anche commovente che vede la problematica dal punto di vista del figlio.
So basically this movie is about surrogate motherhood, so it's a very, very actual topic and very delicate at the same time, and the story is told from the point of view of the son, so the son that doesn't know exactly which is his mother, the natural mother or the cultural mother. So it's really very interesting. Gigi, where we can watch your movie?
Attualmente il film va per i festival, siamo stati invitati al festival di Taormina, al festival di Bari, al B-Fest, e speriamo di portarlo anche al festival del cinema italiano a Miami.
Excellent! So, best of luck for this, I wish you all the best.
Grazie, thank you.
Okay, so now the plate is ready to eat. Egidio, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. It's been a real pleasure. This is yours.
Ah no, questo è un dono che io ti lascio con l'augurio che tu possa vederlo a Londra e che i nostri amici possano vederlo in tutto il mondo.
Grazie.
E
thank you
pen.
So much. Of course. There you go.
Un autografo.
Autograph, yes, please. Okay, so now we need to try.
Oh, it's a very pleasure.
Let's taste the swordfish. What do you think?
Good.
Okay, he likes it, thank God. Thank you so much. Thank you, Egidio. Thank you so much. That's all for today from your favorite Sicilian foodie. I hope you enjoyed. Bye-bye.